Hi, I'm James Montemagno, a program manager for our mobile developer tools here at Microsoft. And today, we're going to see how easy it is to start building our very first iOS and Android application directly inside of Visual Studio 2017. So let's head over to Visual Studio to get started. Here we are inside of Visual Studio 2017. Let's go ahead and create our very first project. Now, inside of our new project dialog, we have a lot of options from Android, iPhone and iPad, and even Apple TV and Watch applications, but we're going to start with cross-platform. And here, I'm going to select the mobile app based on Xamarin Forms. This will give us a shared C# backend for all of our business logic and a shared native user interface powered by XAML. I'm going to select OK. Now here we have a few different options, such as a blank app and the platforms that we want to target. We're then going to select .NET Standard Library as a way of sharing our code across each platform, and simply hit OK. Visual Studio 2017 leaps into action and creates three projects for me: a .NET Standard Library, my Android project, and my iOS project. Let's zoom in and take a little bit closer look. Notice here that I still have a full .NET Standard Library up top called App26. Has all my dependencies and my shared XAML user interface. I also have my Android project and iOS project where I can write platform-specific code because you have access to 100% of the APIs for each platform in C#. But we're going to focus on the shared code in that .NET Standard Library. Well, first note that I have an app XAML, so that's where I can add any shared resources such as colors that I may be using. If I hit the little arrow dropdown, we'll see some code behind app.xaml.cs, the C# file associated with that XAML page. Note here that the application, when starts, will create a new main page. It also has a few lifecycle events, such as on start, on sleep, and on resume. But let's focus on that main page. Here is the bulk of my application. I have a stack layout where I can stack different controls on top of each other. Inside of there is a label that says Welcome to Xamarin Forms. Now I have my Android emulator selected, and we're simply going to start the application. This will fully compile my application on my machine and then deploy it to my Android emulator. So let's give it a few seconds. Here we go. Our application has started up inside of our Android emulator, and what we should see when it's finished loading is Welcome to Xamarin Forms. Now let's do something a little bit more creative. Let's go ahead and add a button on here, and every time we click on it, it will increase the count and we'll display that to our users. So let's hop over to Visual Studio 2017 again. Now I'm going to come in and simply add a button. And here I'll get rich IntelliSense showing me every property that's available. So here's text, and I'll say click me. Then we'll add a clicked event, and we'll say new event handler. This will automatically create the code and the code behind for me that we can implement. We'll simply finish that button element. So let's head to that main page XAML.cs in the code behind, and here's button clicked that we just created. I'm going to create a local variable called count and set it equal to 0. And every time that button is clicked, we'll say count plus plus. Then what we do is simply say that we know that the sender is a button. We want to update the text. There it is. And we'll use some C# interpolation to say you clicked count times. There we go. Now all we have to do is simply redeploy our application. It'll recompile our application with all of our changes and redeploy it into our Android emulator. Here it is, Welcome to Xamarin Forms and a button that says click me. So let's go ahead and click it. There we go. Every single time, we continuously increase that count. Now, we can also set our iOS project as our startup. And if you have a macOS machine, you can go ahead and connect to it and use it as a remote Mac machine to build and compile and use a remoted iOS simulator right on your Windows machine to launch the same exact Android app. Application, but on iOS with an iOS native user interface. To learn more and to get started, go to docs.microsoft.com and tap on Xamarin. That'll give you a full getting started guide, samples, and everything that you need to get started. And there you go. We've built our very first iOS and Android application inside of Visual Studio 2017. If you have any questions at all, please feel free to reach out, and thanks for watching.